lightning bolts that can split trees in half to hailstones so big they can leave dents in your car. Severe summer weather in New England is damaging and it's dangerous, and predicting it, of course, is never easy.
No, it is not. And our own Danielle Vollmar, well, she traveled to a lab in Oklahoma to test out new tools that will give us earlier and more accurate warnings.
Severe weather can hit in an instant. Lately, it seems like storms are more intense and they're drawing more attention.
For example, last year there was a very weak tornado in Stoughton, Massachusetts. Back 10 or 15 years ago, we would have never known about it, but someone got it on video. We came out and surveyed it.
Hayden Frank is one of our local meteorologists at the National Weather Service in Taunton. While he says smartphones and social media are helping to record severe events as they occur, the prediction technology is also improving.
We're able to see smaller circulations that even 10 or 15 years ago we wouldn't have seen.
Each year, the National Weather Service Severe Storms Laboratory in Norman, Oklahoma hosts a group of meteorologists who test out the newest tools for prediction.
These latest cutting-edge technology products are then used by our local weather offices, like this one in Norman or ours in Taunton, to help us issue severe thunderstorm warnings way ahead of schedule.
So this is our probability of severe display. You can see there's contours over individual storms, and they go anywhere from gray to blue to pink. This product will really help the forecasters hone in on which storms need to be further investigated.
The color contours are key, and when you see them trending up to pink, you need to be aware.
Now in this individual storm, you can see it trends from gray to pink really quickly, showing a fast increase in the probability of severe. Some of these other storms that just have a gray contour have a very low probability of becoming severe, so forecasters don't have to spend as much time investigating.
And take a look at this tool. It examines the places that lightning will travel in a specific area, giving us an idea of how intense a storm might grow. For you, it means an earlier and more accurate warning.
Here's Worcester, here's Fenway Park. The most intense part of the storm is way back here, several miles away. But we still have lightning that's coming out towards Fenway Park. We can have a few extra minutes to get the people where they need to be protected from lightning.
The definition of a severe thunderstorm is winds greater than 58 miles per hour and hail 1 inch or greater. Lightning isn't part of the criteria for a severe thunderstorm warning, but it can signal something worse is on the horizon. The more intense the storm, the more danger for you and your family.
Technically now we average 10 to 15 minutes of lead time, so I would expect at least a few minutes improvement. It's going to depend on the situation. Even if it's just a few minutes, that can make a big, big difference, especially if you have a tornado bearing down on you.